Hello students, welcome back to St. Austin's YouTube channel. This is your online mathematics class. We were doing chapter number 3, pair of linear equations in two variable. Today we'll be talking about the parallel lines, intersecting lines and coincidental lines. As you know, we have three types of lines. We have parallel lines, we have intersecting lines, and we have coincidental lines. Okay, what are parallel lines? Parallel lines look something like this. Suppose the equation of this line is, given by a1x plus b1y plus c equals to 0. And the equation of the second line is given by a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. Okay, so these are the equations. So the, here we have two system of, we have two equations in two variables. We have the variable x and we have the variable y. Okay, so how do we just know, just by observation of this equation, how can we decide whether the lines are parallel or not? For the condition of parallelity, we have a1 upon a2 must be equal to b1 upon b2 and this must not be equal to c1 upon c2. This is the condition of the lines to be parallel. Whenever we have two lines given in this format, we have the lines, okay? We know parallel lines never intersect each other. And when we did the graphical representation, we studied that at whichever points the two lines intersect, that will give us the solution of the two equations, right? Now, since the parallel lines are not at all intersecting at any point, this means the such kind of lines, they do not have any solution. So here we can write, they do not have any solution. Such equation which do not have any solution are called inconsistent The equations which do not have any solution are known as inconsistent equations. So such lines, such equations will be inconsistent. Okay. Parallel lines, for the case of parallel lines, we will never find the solution, and such case is known as inconsistent. Okay. Next we have intersecting lines. What are intersecting lines? When two lines intersect at a point, okay, when they cut each other at a single point, such lines are known as intersecting lines. Suppose here also we are taking the equation as a1x plus b1y plus c1 equals to 0, and the equation for the second line would be a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. These are the two equations of the given line. Now, since these lines are intersecting at a point, this definitely means that they have a common solution. And how do we find that common solution? For that, we have different methods which we have discussed earlier. We can either draw their graphs and we can find out the coordinates of this intersecting point, or we can apply the elimination method, we can apply the cross multiplication method, or we can apply the substitution method. Okay, the condition for intersection of lines will be given by a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2 and which is not equal to c1 upon c2. This will be the condition for the intersection of two lines. Okay, next, since these lines have a solution, the pair of equations have a solution, so this is called consistent equations. These two equations, in this case, the equations which has a solution are called consistent equations. Okay. Next, we have coincidental lines. Coincidental lines means two lines when lie on each other. two lines when lie upon one another, they are known as coincidental lines. Suppose the equation of first line is given by a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, and the equation of second is also given by a2x plus b2y plus c2 equals to 0. These are the two equations for the two lines given to us. How do we check the condition for coincidence? The condition for coincidence will be given by a1 upon a2 equals to b1 upon b2 equal to c1 upon c2. This is the condition of coincidence. And as we know, the two lines are lying on top of each other. That means every point present on the line will give us the solution for the two equations. So these two equations also have multiple solutions. Here only one solution, only one intersecting point was there. So only one solution, or we can say unique solution, was possible. And here see, there can be infinite number of points lying on these two lines. So here we have multiple solutions possible. All the points lying on the line will be the solutions for the equations. Okay, this is the condition for coincidence of two lines. This is the condition for intersection of two lines. And this is the condition for the parallelity of two lines. Let us see this with the help of an example. For example, the system of equation given to us is 2x plus 3y equal to 6, 4x plus 6y equal to 10. Okay, so here see the value of a1. A1 is the coefficient of x. The value of a1 is 2. The value of b1, b1 is the coefficient of y. The value of b1 is 3. And c1, c1 is the constant. Constant here is 6. Okay, here the value of a2 will be 4, the value of b2 will be 6, and the value of c2 will be 10. Now if we are comparing the, with this, these were our conditions 1, 2 and 3. So let's just divide, let's just take the ratio. A1 upon a2 equal to a1 upon a2, 2 by 4, this comes out to be 1 by 2. B1 upon B2 is 3 by 6. This is also equals to 1 by 2. C1 upon C2. C1 upon C2 is equals to 6 by 10, which is 3 by 5. See, here A1 upon A2 is equals to B1 upon B2, and this is not equal to C1 upon C2. So this is this case. This was the case of parallelity of two lines. So again, from here we can say, hence given lines are parallel to each other, and since they have they are parallel, so this implies the equations have no solution. The equations are inconsistent. And have no solution. So this is how we'll be doing the questions based on the conditions. Okay, so this is all for today's video. Thank you.